Welcome to day two of On the Road with Good Day Bio at the BioInvestor Forum in San Francisco. I'm your host, Teresa Brady. The pace of networking, learning, collaborating, and deal-making did not slow down this second day. When we left you last night, we were headed to the welcome reception. It was a great way for attendees to continue networking in a more relaxed atmosphere. We caught up with a group there called Women in Bio.
And we're here unwinding at the Bio Welcome Reception after a long day of eventful programming and partnering. And I'm here with Dr. Selva Raja, who's in Women in Bio. Can you tell us a little bit about the Women in Bio organization?
The Women in Bio that I'm familiar with is where we have programs around different biotechs, and women are invited to network. And it has been a great opportunity because I meet other scientists just like me, and I've got in touch with them later on LinkedIn and kept in touch. So it's a great networking tool in an ecosystem like the San Francisco biotech.
And so this community, they're really there to support each other, and not only support each other, but to encourage other women in the industry to take on leadership roles. What message would you have for those young women who are working in the biotech industry?
Yeah, I always try to meet the graduates and postgraduates in these meetings so I can tell them about the biotech career, because a lot of us don't think about it. That there are so many opportunities for women, and apply and meet people and apply for jobs, because you know I would take as many women as men in my team. So I think they should really give it a good shot, and there's a lot of opportunities out here.
And again, that's what the Women in Bio group is for. It's there to support each other, but also to inspire other women in the industry to take on those leadership roles. Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
An important goal for Bio is to accelerate gender, racial, ethnic, and LGBTQ representation on biotech boards and C-suites and leadership positions. For more information on Bio's Right Mix Matters campaign, visit rightmixmatters.org. A unique opportunity at this conference is the company presentation. Companies have 13 minutes to give their best pitch, discuss their pipelines, and talk about future goals to an exclusive audience. Connor McCoy talked with a few of them about their experience.
And how critical are these company presentations at the BioInvestor Forum for your business?
It's always important to get your story out there and to connect with the movers and shakers of our industry, and so those people are definitely here. And so to present the story and to connect with new and existing friends in the industry is always a great opportunity.
And how did your presentation go?
I think it went well. I think there's people in the room that are obviously interested in what the future has in store, and I think Aspect definitely has a place in the future when we think of creating personalized tissue therapeutics.
What a great opportunity for these companies to present before this critical mass of decision makers. One of those decision makers headlined our fireside chat today. Wendy Hutton is general partner of Canaan, an early stage venture capital firm that invests and transformative ideas. Wendy's investments have delivered more than a dozen innovations to patients.
Wendy, what do you look for in early stage companies when you invest?
First and foremost, when a great entrepreneur walks through the door with exceptional vision around new science, that captivates me. And we're also looking for that entrepreneur to bring forward technologies and therapies for unmet clinical needs.
And what's the key takeaway from your fireside chat today?
We've been in an unprecedented time of scientific and clinical breakthroughs, which is really quite amazing in oncology, cell therapy, gene therapy, rare disease. But some storm clouds are out ahead, and I think all entrepreneurs should be aware of that.
As Wendy mentioned, there's a lot of factors that she looks for when it comes to investing in early stage companies. Back to you, Teresa.
Yesterday, we talked to you about our amazing partnering system that most of our attendees take advantage of. For many of these companies, it's not the first time they've used it, and so we've created a new group called Triple Crown Partners. Triple Crown Partners have completed a trio of Bio's partnering meetings: Bio Investor Forum, Bio One-on-One Partnering at JPM, and Bio CEO and Investor Conference. These partners received special recognition at this event. Here to talk with us is Norman Rogers of American Gene Technologies, a Triple Crown partner who was profiled on our blog, Biotech Now.
Thanks, Teresa. And I'm standing here with Norman, who obviously is a pro when it comes to BIO's one-on-one partnering. Without giving away any secrets, can you give a sense of the type of connections you've been able to make?
Absolutely. I've had the opportunity just in the last 2 days to meet two individuals who participated in discovery teams that were curative for diseases, major diseases, including hepatitis C. I'm just profoundly excited to be able to meet people of this caliber.
And what keeps you coming back to BIO's One Partnering? You've obviously done this at previous BIO events. What's bringing you back?
The ability to use a partnering system to connect with incredible people with incredible ideas.
Thanks, Connor. And there were more stimulating panel sessions today. One of them covered venture investment in AI-focused biopharma, which reached a new high this year. We talked with a panelist from one of those AI-driven companies as she came off the podium. Here's Connor with more.
Thanks, Teresa. There certainly is a lot of excitement in AI, especially in biopharma. I'm standing here with Dr. Deshpande, who just came off the panel where that was the focus. Doctor, what do you think is driving the interest in AI in biopharma?
So I would say there are two main factors that are driving the interest in this space. One is the promise that AI has for improving the speed, time, and cost. The other is that we're starting to see a whole new class of investors starting to fund companies in the space, which is exciting.
And what are some insights that you gained from your panel?
So two key takeaways. One is AI stands for augmented intelligence. It really isn't at the point where we can refer to it as artificial intelligence. There's still a lot of human component that goes into taking what's coming out of technology and then turning that into drugs that'll get into the clinic and eventually to patients. And the other key takeaway is that a lot of the companies that were on the panel today are really focused on actually developing the drugs that are coming out of their technologies.
Thank you.
The AI panel was one of many informative sessions here at the BioInvestor Forum. BIO's president of our membership and business operations division talked to our attendees about the benefits of this conference, as well as others, including the BIO International Convention, which will be back in California next June.
I can tell by the buzz in this room, as well as in the hallway, that there are a lot of really good conversations taking place, both in the partnering system and in our event, in the reception area. So it's going well. And our hope is that those conversations that you make here will continue, will turn into partnerships for you and other business collaborations. But what we try to strive to do at BIO is we strive to create an environment where the biotech innovators can find investors and strategic partners to advance your company to that next stage in your business life cycle. So we're hoping through this event and all of the events that we hold throughout the country and throughout the world are very productive for you and using our BIO 101 partnering system.
Well, that's a wrap from the BIO Investor Forum in San Francisco. Thank you for watching On the Road with Good Day BIO.
And be sure to join us for another edition of On the Road with Good Day BIO coming to you next week from the Patient Health and Advocacy Summit. And look for more shows in 2020, including coverage of the BIO International Convention back here in California.